Hey, I got a job for you.
You got a job for me?
Yeah. There's a bunch of dead freaks. The west of the footbridge stuck in the muck. I need someone to pull them out and take them to the burn pile. Got it?
Marsh duty.
Yeah.
Get someone else. I'm busy.
Hey, I'm getting you to do it. I don't know what Mike told you on your little field trip, but we got work to do. Here.
Hey. Schizo, he can't come with you, he's coming with me.
Last I checked, I wasn't talking to you.
Well, I checked in with Mike. I gotta go into the shit, and he's coming with me. All right?
Like I said, I'm busy.
And when you get back, you come find me.
You coming?
Where?
Doesn't matter.
Seriously, where are we headed?
North.
Ricky, I don't have time for your crap any more than Schizo's.
Come on, I'll show you. Mike told me what you did.
I didn't do anything.
About how if we seal the caves here, we can stop the hordes.
Never said it would stop them. Maybe slow them down. Look, are you going somewhere with this?
Yeah. I just thought that maybe you decided to stay. I mean, not just because of Boozer, but because you wanted to help.
Is that what you thought? Hey, back in the day, I did my share of runs.
You did, but never anything more than that, and you know it. So now you're helping Iron Mike seal the caves? What did you want me to think? A few weeks back, we lost a man when this went down, shutting down the infirmary's respirator.
Respirator? Oh, God. Ricky, look around. If you're on a respirator out here, you're already dead.
What if it'd been Boozer? Yeah, that's what I thought. See, we haven't had power for almost 2 years, but the transformers and the lines, they all check out. Well, at least they do here. I want to ride up north, check out the hydro dam, just to see why it shut down.
Oh no, riding escort, that's Schizo's job.
I don't need an escort. You lived up there, you know the area better than anyone. Deacon, you asked for my help, right? Now I'm asking for yours. Okay, good. I'm gonna go grab some of the guys
that
can rut.
No, you're not. No, we're going in quiet. We're running to Copeland's men. I can handle them, but that wilderness up there is crawling with rippers and scumbags and God knows what else. More men, you know what that means? I mean more attention. No, no, we're doing this my way.
Shit. Fine. Okay, let's go.
Look, Ricky, I gotta ask you. The other night, in the infirmary.
Would I have shot you in the face? No.
Really? Oh. From the look on your face, you...
I would have taken you outside first and then shot you in the face.
Okay, so you wouldn't, want to get blood all over the infirmary.
Uh-huh, exactly.
If we get an early start, we can get back before dark.
As long as nothing goes wrong.
Well, what can go wrong? Following you?
Just follow the route that I marked on your map. There's some marauder camps up there we want to stay away from. So how did you end up out here? I never asked you.
Same as everyone, I guess. When shit went down, I was 100 miles from home. By the time I got back, everyone was gone.
Where are you from?
Grew up in a little town outside of Portland. Would work in the city, couch surf, go home on weekends.
Big city.
Yeah, right. Only in Oregon.
What was it like over there? I mean, how did you get out?
I don't know. Luck, I guess. Roads were backed up all the way down the coast. One giant parking lot. Willamette Valley was a war zone. Everything happened so fast. I told my friends to get out when I left. I don't think they listened to me.
I heard they nuked it.
Portland? Yeah, I heard that too. Don't think it's true. We'd be feeling the fallout, right?
Yeah. So, you and Addy.
You got a problem?
Me? No. Come on. I didn't know. You rode with us a long time. I guess it never came up.
I was like you. Seemed like, I don't know, keeping your distance was just a good way to stay alive.
Okay, look, I shouldn't have asked. None of my business.
That's why I'm at the camp. You know, chance to live a normal life again.
Good luck with that.
It's nothing serious. Me and Addy?
Didn't look that way to me.
Yeah, well, things happen fast these days. You know what I mean?
Didn't ask. I wanted to tell you something.
Shoot.
Look, I appreciate you going to bat for me. For me and Boozer. With Iron Mike, I mean.
Wow, you are getting soft.
Fuck off.
You've never thanked me for anything.
Yeah, well, maybe I never had any reason to.
Okay. So where did you and Iron Mike go the other day?
Wait, you said that he already told you about it.
He was pretty tight-lipped. I've known Iron Mike a long time. To be honest, I don't think I've ever seen him so, I don't know, depressed. Where'd you go?
A Sherman's camp.
I heard that place was a freak show.
It is, but we didn't have much of a choice. I had an idea about sealing the caves, keep the hordes from coming through. He knew where the mining claims office was. We picked up some maps. He's gonna track down some explosives.
Your radio must be broken. Almost sounded like you volunteered for some shit.
I'm riding with you now, aren't I? Jesus.
You just wanted out of marsh duty.
Okay, you got me.
So what happened? Something happened.
Nothing, Ricky. Nothing happened.
He didn't say anything?
Just no. No. Nothing happened. And no, Iron Mike didn't say anything. Like you said, he's a pretty tight-lipped guy. All right, dam's coming up. Take it slow near the gate. No idea who or what might be living there.
Got it.
Well, looks clear.
Are you expecting trouble?
Yeah, always. And if we run into any, we're gone.
All right, come on. I want to check the outflow.
Where are you going?
Down here. Oh, no. Hey, this isn't right. There should be more water flowing out right there.
Yeah?
Yeah, and you hear that?
What?
Exactly. If the turbines were running, you'd be able to hear the hum of the lines from here. Oh. What happened there?
Oh. Same thing that happened to all the bridges. Smart men in uniforms decided blowing them up would keep the hordes from coming in.
Hordes of refugees or hordes of freaks?
Well, you figure men like Copeland? Probably both.
All right, come on, I want to check something out. Come here, touch this. Come on. Okay. You feel anything?
No.
Exactly. If more water was flowing, the turbines would be vibrating. Come on. Oh,
Up this way. We're going all the way up to the top, up there.
Following you.
See these pipes? They're called the penstock. Water pressure builds up from the reservoir and is pushed down through those pipes, concentrating the force of the flow, which goes right through to the turbines.
How the hell do you know all this stuff?
I had two older brothers who were always fixing cars and shit with my dad. He got me a job at Boeing when I was only 17. I was going to school part-time to become a mechanical engineer when shit went down.
Did you ever see him again? Your dad, brothers?
No. Come on, over here.
All right, let's figure this out. Well, this is gonna be fun.
So now wait, what's going on? What are you doing?
We only rode together a few months, but in all that time, I never saw you volunteer for anything. One of us has to jump down there and clear the intake. So, I'm up. Oh, but you can stand and watch. Okay. Oh, it's now or never. Let's go.
Yeah, it's pretty mucked up. I think I could clear it, though. Run back down to the turbine. See if it's vibrating at all.
Nothing. Wait a second. There it is. Yep, that did it.
Ha! You feel that vibration?
Yeah, but the power lines are still dead.
What? Man, oh, it couldn't be that easy, right? All right, come on, let's check out the transformers.
So, your dad and your brothers, what happened to them?
I don't know. On my way back, I tried calling over and over. I always got a busy signal. By the time I reached the house, it was deserted. The entire neighborhood was deserted. There were flyers everywhere, evacuation orders. I went to the closest refugee camp, but it was overrun. Everyone was dead. Freaks were everywhere.
Jesus, Ricky, I'm real sorry.
Yeah, it was a long time ago.
But these are the ones feeding the lines going south.
Any idea what's wrong with them?
No, not a clue. Okay. Well, it might be a short in the turbine junction boxes, so let's just go down and check it out. Okay?
All right.
So, what's with you and Schizo? I mean, it seems like you're always on the verge of ripping his throat out.
A few months back, Eddie and I caught him hiding outside our cabin while we were bathing.
What? God, he's a peeping Tom.
I told him if it happened again, he'd find out that my gun is bigger than his.
Jesus. You know, if Addie was there, Schizo probably wasn't looking at you.
It was all I could do to stop her from neutering the bastard.
Ouch.
Right? Never piss off a woman who knows how to use this cap. Here, boost me up.
Okay, got it.
Here, I got the gate. Come on, junction room's right around here.
Oh, God, what is that smell?
Freaker nests. From the smell of it, more than a couple. Stay close. How many Molotovs you got with you?
Enough.
Okay.
Remember the drill. You light him up, I knock him down.
It's been a while, but I remember.
Light her up. Ready?
Oh, yeah.
Got it. There we go. Light her up. You good?
Yeah. They really don't like visitors much, do they?
Well, can you blame them?
Whew. Well, they better get used to this shit. You know what? As of today, I'm claiming this for Lost Lake Camp.
Power to the people.
All right, let's check the junction boxes and get the hell out of here. This is it. You ready?
Yep.
Yes! Houston, we have power.
Nice work.
Oh, I couldn't have done it without you.
Come on, let's find something to block the door in. I don't want to have to come back up here every month to clean this shit out.
Wait. You're gonna be here in a month?
What? No, I don't know. Would you just... Jesus.
I'm just fucking with you, Geek. Come on. So, why'd you ask about my dad and my brothers?
I don't know. He just, you never mentioned him before, so, you know, I'm sorry if I, if it's, something you didn't want to talk about.
Oh, that's fine. I'm gonna ask you.
Okay, Ricky, not now. You can ask me later.
Hey.
Come on, we gotta get moving.
Hey, you never asked why I stopped riding with you and Boozer.
Was I supposed to ask? I already knew why. Iron Mike's bullshit. God, Ricky, do we gotta do this now?
We had been riding together for, I don't remember, a couple months. Deacon, come on.
Okay.
There was this one night, and I remember it really clearly. It was snowing outside, and Boozer was snoring. You remember how he used to snore? I swear, I thought he was going to bring a horde down on us,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, pretty much hasn't changed.
Anyway, you thought everyone was asleep, and you were sitting outside by yourself like you always did, and you were staring at something. You didn't sleep the whole night. Let me see the photo, Deke. Come on, please. This is when I knew.
What'd you know, Ricky?
That I didn't want to end up like so many of us here. We're trapped in the past or running from it. I want to look forward. Okay? Not back.
This isn't what you think it is, okay?
Get low! We're on the back! Find them!
Are you sure it's them?
I saw the mark on his back!
We're from Lost Lake Camp! Iron Mike has a treaty!
Hey. Well, that was a really good idea. You want to try that again?
Yes.
Stay put and keep your head down.
Stop.
Yeah? I'm gonna kill him.
I'm coming!
You assholes are kind of far from home, aren't you?
What are you doing?
Dragged your ass back to Iron Butte to find the shithole you crawled out from!
We have a treaty!
Far north, aren't you? Huh? You don't want to get too far away from Carlos, do you? Leave you here to bleed out, huh? Make all the freaks out here happy, yeah? Huh? Isn't that what you want? You can all just go straight to hell!
Oh, yeah, nice and blue down there for you, huh?
We have lost many to them!
I think that's the last of them.
I should look at this. What the hell are they amped up on?
No idea. Back in the day, dealt with a few tweakers who acted like that. I think they're on PCP or whatever that other shit is.
Oh, bath salts. Remember? That was becoming a thing before everything went down.
Right, yeah. Come on, let's see if they messed up our bikes. think that Iron Mike's treaty with these bastards is gonna hold?
I don't know.
Fucking rippers, after what they did to Boozer's arm, after what they did to
Dick!
Lisa, what?
This was clutched in one of their hands. What happened? Did you guys have a run-in, you and Boozer, with the rippers before you stole the antibiotics?
Well, I don't know. Look, whatever Carlos thinks I did, ain't gonna compare to what I'm gonna do to him if I ever see the son of a bitch.
Come on, let's go.